Hi, I'm Kody, a security researcher with Varonis. And today, we're going to talk a little bit about the risks of working at home when you don't have an IT department backing you up. This is my friend Tim, and today he's going to be playing our victim when I demonstrate how an attacker can use social engineering and some technical skills to break into someone's home Wi-Fi network and do all sorts of bad stuff. So we're going to use a wireless network adapter like this, which I got on AliExpress for, I think, $12. But you can also just pick up an Alpha wireless network adapter because they all work pretty well with Kali Linux, which is what I'm using today. Now, jumping onto my screen, I'm using a tool called AirGetIn, which is a multi-use bash script for Linux systems to audit wireless networks. And that's exactly what it is. It is excellent at executing a number of highly technical attacks against Wi-Fi networks. So today, we're going to go and take a look at one of my favorite ones, which is a captive portal. Now, Tim is currently connected to a Wi-Fi network called Tim Spectacular. And what we've already done is kicked him off for just a second in order to grab what's called a Wi-Fi handshake. Now, this isn't the password. It's basically a hash of the password. And what we can do with this is try to compare a guess against it and see if we get the same result. If we do, then we have the right password. And the way that is valuable is in two different ways. One, to do a brute force attack, or if I'm lazy and I want to trick Tim, I can just get him to tell me the password, check it against the handshake I have, and if it's right, then I will effectively just stop attacking him. So the way things are going to work is this. As soon as I decide which language I want my phishing page to be in, I'm going to kick Tim off of his network consistently and pop up a fake network that looks just like Tim Spectacular, but it won't have any security on it. As soon as he's no longer able to do his job, he'll see there's another Wi-Fi network out there with the same name as his, connect to it, and immediately be redirected to a page in whatever language I select, which pretends to be from his router, and is telling him he needs to update, and will accept nothing but the correct password in order to release the stranglehold on his Wi-Fi network. Now what's really happening here is I'm creating a fake Wi-Fi network, allowing him to connect, hosting a little server that has this page, and redirecting any requests to my fake phishing page telling him it's the router. And fair disclosure, I've actually fallen for this myself back when I worked at a startup. Now I'm going to go ahead and select option number one to start all of the attacks, and Tim is going to be browsing or doing whatever it is he's doing, and he'll notice immediately that the first result of this attack will be he'll no longer be able to access the internet, and suddenly we'll start to see a new Wi-Fi network that is created as well. Here you can see that my wireless network is creating a fake Wi-Fi network called Tim Spectacular, and as these other windows spin up, I'll begin other phases of the attack and begin to be able to impact his ability to access his own secure wireless network. As you can
see, the site can't be reached.
All right, let's switch over to Tim's side. So it looks like already he's having a hard time accessing the internet, and as boxes start popping up on my Linux machine, he will no longer be able to access things at all. And you can see that now, if you go ahead and check, currently connected, but boom, kicked off. Yeah. All right, so back to my screen, we can see that all sorts of stuff is going on. We are now sending deauthentication packets, kicking Tim off of his legitimate network. We're hosting a fake fake phishing page on our server, and we are also doing DNS spoofing, which means any attempt to go to any website is going to instead go to our phishing page. We've even got this web server up to basically see if we've tricked anyone into connecting to our hacking server. So now Tim is going to go ahead and switch back to his screen. We'll see him try to connect to a network, but instead find that there is a TimsNet that has gone rogue with no password, connect to it. When Tim attempts to go to a website in Firefox, it immediately redirects him to a phishing page. Now, this phishing page is not the most sophisticated, but if he tries to type in the wrong password, go ahead and do so. This is different from a phishing page that would just accept anything, and you can see it says the password is incorrect and redirects him. Now back on my screen, you can see that we saw this is not the right password was the last attempt, and we compared that to the handshake we grabbed earlier and basically figured out that this was wrong. So now Tim's like, all right, this thing already knows my password. I might as well give it my password to complete this router update. Go ahead and put in your password. Tim will stay on my screen. And this is what the hacker sees when the victim puts in their password.
All right.
Boom, there we go. Tim's terrible secret. So this immediately stops our attack. As soon as we find a password that matches the handshake we captured earlier, we know we've got the right one. So we stop attacking Tim's network, shut down our fake server and our fake network, and basically boot him off, and his machine should automatically reconnect back to the old network. That kind of squares with our deception here of pretending to be the router rebooting, and it's a really simple way that a hacker could break into a network while causing someone to think it's just a technical glitch. This has been a simple example of how a hacker can take advantage of people working from home who might not understand what their router's update page should look like, and that it should never ask for your Wi-Fi password, only the administrator password. Now, this might not seem like a big deal to have a hacker break into your home Wi-Fi network, but when you're working from home, that hacker could target your work or even target your router to begin doing all sorts of suspicious and sketchy things with your internet connection. I'm Kody with Varonis, this has been Tim, and we just want to hope that you guys stay safe. So if you have any questions, you can hit me up on Twitter at Kody Kinzie, and stay safe out there.
Bye.